Hi, this is Brian with Prophetless Media and Post, and today I was going to do a quick tip tutorial on how you can use the magic mask to occlude objects when you're using the planar tracker. I had a comment recently on one of my videos and thought I'd do a quick video on how you can put this together. So here we have this clip of a guy on a bike going through the woods here, and say we wanted to add some text here on the grass. So let's add in a planar tracker, and let's connect our main footage to it. Say we want to track this area, just track a large area. Now, one of the things taken into consideration when you have a larger area is that even if you have a moving object going through it, it may not disturb the planar tracker. The planar tracker is actually pretty good. Let's just see how this works right away. I'm going to hit set for the reference time. I'm going to leave everything else at default and just start tracking forward. Okay, I want to stop right here. And you can see that it's actually picking up points on his leg and some of the tire and stuff like that. Now, this may not be that big of a deal because it looks like the planar tracker is actually working. But if it wasn't and you wanted to use a mask to help with the planar tracker, let's see how we can do that. So I'm going to hit set to reset this. And I want to take the magic mask, which I did earlier, which is a real time saver for something like this, where, you know, this is a pretty complicated object to rotoshape, and it did a pretty good job. So what you want to be able to do is take this mask, and if we look at the planar tracker, you want to add it into the little white triangle, which says occlusion mask. So that's where we want to add it. So if I add it into there and we look through, and we are on the right frame, let's just track through. Okay, I'm going to stop it right there because you can see that the planar tracker is not recognizing the mask. One of the ways that we can remedy that is by using a bitmap. So I'm going to add in a bitmap. We're going to add that in. We're going to take our magic mask, add it into the yellow. And once we do that, you can see now we have this solid alpha in the planar tracker will recognize this mask. So I drop that in there now. This should help. But before we do that, I actually want to kind of expand out this mat so that none of the edges catch, because this is actually pretty tight. So what we can do is add in a mat control. And the mat control is into the background. And if we look through there, let's blur it a little bit and expand it. Okay, so that should do a great job on blocking this out. So let's go back to the planar tracker. Let's go back to our reference frame. I'm going to hit set to reset everything. And then let's track forward and see what happens. And now you can see that there's an edge outside. It's not tracking his leg. So that's how you can use your magic mask to occlude objects that might be running through your planar tracker and help you improve your planar track. Just go through and kind of finish this off, but that's the basic gist of it. And why don't we just finish this off and put in the text. So now we want to put in our text over here. So let's grab a text. And we'll put in something clever like BMX. And we want to merge to grab a merge. I'm going to put that in here and put the text in the foreground. So we have it here. Now we just need to position it. So I'm going to take, we can use a corner positioner. I'm going to add that in. And just to make it a little bit easier, I'm going to make the text much larger, so that it fits inside this corner positioner better. And let's position this where we want it. Yeah, say something like that. And so now we just need to add in the planar transform. So let's go to our planar tracker. And there's a couple of ways you can do this, but for this one, we're just going to do create planar transform here at the bottom, and that's going to create this node. Holding shift, I'm going to drag it in here, Oops, now I moved it a little bit because the reference frame is on frame 216 and we set it at 250. So let's just move that back into position. Yeah, something like that. That's fine. And so that should have our motion. So now we have our motion. Now the last thing we need to do is bring in our mask to make it look like the biker is going through the words. So we have that information already from our magic mask. So we'll go right from the bitmap. Take that. We can drop it right into our mask of on the merge. Now if we look through, you can see it's just the opposite of what we want. One way we can do that is inside the merge. Go to settings and apply mask converted. And now the letters are in the background. We have everything lined up. And that looks pretty good. So anyway, I rambled on long enough. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial, and I'll see you again in the next one.